finger, it's not really that big of a deal. If you get super glue or cyanoacrylate on your finger, it's going to take a while to get it off. Even with debonder, it still turns your fingers white, which is really stupid looking, but hey, that's the way it works. All right, there's two horses done. Now, I like to do what I call randomizing, which is basically, you know, I'll assemble all the pieces that I know need to be assembled, like all the horse bodies I'll assemble, but I'll leave all the heads off. And then what I'll do is I'll shut my eyes and I'll pick one body and one head, all right? And those are the ones that go together, you know? It just helps keep the models more sporadic when you're putting them together. But yeah, it's a good technique to use. I like it. I have, some of you could probably tell this just by the way I film stuff, but I have I used to have massive obsessive compulsive disorder. It's gotten much better lately, and I've learned to just kind of go with the flow and just do whatever. And so I've actually sort of turned it around and become more of a free spirit than just being locked into a certain pattern of doing things. But when I first got started painting miniatures, oh, that was weird. Just shot a piece of the horse all the way across my table. When I first got started in painting miniatures, I remember I had a box of Catachan jungle fighters, and it took me almost 4 days to put them together because I wanted to make sure they were all in just the right pose, and you know that I had just the right arms with the correct body style, and it was a nightmare. It really was. And now, you know, I just say the heck with it. However they end up is how they end up, and it really does kind of make the models look better. Now, I will sort of pose the models, but as far as, like, specifically, like, looking on a sprue and trying to figure out which piece would go best with which other pieces, I don't do that anymore, because it's just way too time-consuming. All right, and I keep dropping these little pieces. All right, now I'll see here. Okay, just like this. I'm curious, leave some comments below. I have sort of come up with a way to help you guys save on your miniature costs. And what it is basically casting your own models. You would take something like, you know, if you wanted to do one of these horses, you would basically take them off a sprue, cast them, and then you'd have two horses, obviously. Would anybody be interested in seeing something like that actually happen? Because, you know, it's one thing to say, yeah, sure, it'd be neat to see, but is there anybody out there that would actually do it if I taught you how to do it? I've been thinking about doing, you know, just a quick little video on it, and then maybe doing a DVD on how to cast your own models. Not that I would ever tell you to infringe on anyone's copyrights and actually copy a Games Workshop model. No, that would be horrible. Don't do that, please, no. This would only be for if you had sculpted your own miniatures. Wink, 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 wink. Now, that being said, would anybody be interested in learning how to cast some of your own miniatures, wink, wink, if I were to show you how to do it? And that way, you know, you could save, potentially, on the cost of certain models, all right? Now, again, I don't know. I'm just throwing it out there because if putting a model together, if going out and buying a miniature costs, let's say it's just a standard metal model from like Reaper or something, so you're only paying $5 for it, okay, at the most. More than likely you're paying $3. So let's say you pay $3 for a miniature, but you could create a mold of that miniature, though you're not supposed to. Again, let me throw that out there. You are only supposed to create molds of miniatures that you make, but suppose you did make a mold of this miniature, and you could cast it and make duplicates of that miniature, and doing the whole thing would cost you materials and everything per figure, maybe 75, 80 cents. You know, would anybody be interested in learning something like that? Just throw some comments down in the bottom. And if I get enough response, I'll go ahead and do it. I've had a couple people ask me how to cut costs on gaming, and that right there is probably one of the biggest things that you can do. And, you know, honestly, the way I look at it is kind of like this. It, for me, even if you're casting a miniature that belongs to a company, like, you know, if I wanted to take these two halves of these horses, and I made a mold of each half of the horse, all right, to me, as long as I'm only using it for my personal business and I'm not actually going out and selling them, that's fine. It almost reminds me of, most of you guys don't know, well, some of you guys might know what this is. Some of you guys might remember back in the 80s, these things that came around called a mixtape. All right, make them for your girlfriend or whatever it was, you know. It was basically just a copy of a bunch of songs, you know. And even in today's world, I kind of liken it to, you know, if you buy a CD, you might, you know, rip it onto your computer in MP3 format and then burn that onto, for instance, your iPod or something. Okay, so you now have two copies of a CD even though you only purchased one, all right. That's the way I kind of look at it. And so, if anybody's interested in learning how to do that, let me know, and I'll go ahead and teach you guys how to do it. I gotta tell you, it is a huge, huge cost saver. It really is. But it does take some time to learn how to do, and it takes some time to actually do the casting itself. So, again, if anybody's interested, just let me know, and we might do some videos on it. Alright, let's see here. What else can we chat about? I don't know. I really don't like this song, but that's okay. Yikes. Highway 52 and 119. And all lanes have been blocked, have been shut down for a while. And that's why I'm getting the calls and the text messages from Amber. Who says, I'm sitting on the highway for an hour with no air conditioning in my car. What's going on? Amber, enjoy the sweat because you're going to be there a while. All lanes blocked, 5-car accident between Highway 52 and 119. How you guys like the new DVD covers? Those are really, really sweet. I was blown away. Damien did an awesome, awesome job on those things. And, I mean, everybody here loved them. And I'm just unbelievable looking, you know. And just a really nice guy, too. But great looking stuff.